My name is Gabe Monroe. I'm a research mechanical engineer with ERDC's Geotechnical and Structures Laboratory. I'm part of the team that works on the virtual autonomous navigation environment, which is leading the way in ground vehicle ability simulation for autonomous unmanned ground vehicles. ERDC has been conducting physical mobility experiments since World War II. The data from these experiments went into empirical models that could be used to estimate the vehicle mobility for a given soil strength, both for wheeled and tracked vehicles. In the 1970s, this work resulted in the NATO Reference Mobility Model, or NRMM. NRMM has been used extensively both in the development of new vehicles and in operational planning for existing vehicles, producing mobility maps for go, no-go, or top speed. This line of work continued for several more decades, and we continue to perform physical experiments for ground vehicles. As ground vehicle systems began to incorporate modern sensors such as GPS, LiDAR, or cameras, we developed the Virtual Autonomous Navigation Environment, or VANE. We use VANE to augment physical experiments and allow us to look at how the physical world impacts the entire vehicle system, from the sensors to the running gear. VANE is particularly valuable to the development of unmanned ground vehicles, or UGVs. This is because autonomous vehicles rely on sensors to perceive and navigate the world. So now, our physics-based simulations of sensor-environment interactions are as important as our vehicle terrain expertise and modeling. On the surface, there seems to be a lot of similarities between the technology and the goals of, Google or Tesla's modeling simulation tools and VANE. Using modeling simulation, you can explore all the different combinations of scenarios or conditions that could impact an autonomous vehicle's behavior. Thus, you can develop an understanding of its limitations and trust in its capabilities. However, the Army's autonomy problems are much more challenging and more diverse than in the civilian sector. We don't operate on paved roads with painted lines, bright lights, and assured GPS connectivity, which is why we've developed unique tools to address military problems. Being able to predict vehicle behavior in edge case conditions is valuable to both manned and unmanned vehicles, but looking at UGVs specifically, if a commander is to deploy a UGV alongside or in place of manned assets, they have to have confidence that the UGV can accomplish the mission. VANE is a suite of tools that encompasses everything needed to perform software-in-the-loop simulations of autonomous vehicles, including virtual models of the environment, the vehicle, and the sensors. The component tools of VANE are useful independently to address specific issues, such as generating synthetic training data for better algorithms, or identifying the ideal sensor placement on a vehicle. But together, the VANE tools allow us to perform software-in-the-loop simulations, where an autonomous algorithm thinks it's controlling an actual vehicle in the real world. This lets us see how the autonomy will react to various conditions or situations that might be too difficult, dangerous, or time-consuming in reality. We still have to have real-world data to validate the simulations, but VANE lets you answer more questions than physical experiments alone. Looking at the software-in-the-loop simulations that I mentioned earlier, there are four main components. You have the virtual world, you have the virtual sensors that look at that world and then pass data to the autonomy, you have the autonomy itself as it's processing that data, and then you have the virtual vehicle models that the autonomy sends commands to navigate that virtual world. For the virtual world, we're considering attributes like the geometry of structures and the terrain, the type and density of vegetation, the lighting and environmental conditions, or the colors and textures of surfaces. Sometimes we develop geotypical environments that do not represent a specific place, but often we will create a digital twin of a real-world location so the simulations and physical experiments can be directly compared with each other. These images are from an Unreal scene that we developed of an Army training facility in Michigan. For these types of geospecific scenes, we will collect high-resolution LiDAR scans of the physical site and normalized RGB and hyperspectral images of site surfaces. We will also collect ecology data to inform the placement of vegetation models. We will use all this data to build a virtual world where we can change the lighting, the weather, or even the time of year at will. Autonomous vehicles often rely on multiple sensor modalities to perceive the world, such as LiDAR, radar, IMUs, cameras, or GPS. For VANE, we use manufacturer data to establish the basic parameters of a sensor model, such as camera focal length or the number of beams in a LiDAR. But we also perform validation experiments to confirm that our models match reality. That includes nominal sensor behavior, and common errors are distortions, such as motion blur or GPS drift. The real world can be messy. If VANE provided a pristine, error-free sensor feed to an autonomous algorithm to process, we shouldn't expect the autonomy to behave the same way in simulation as it would in the real world. Thus, it's crucial that VANE accurately simulates sensor-environment interactions, including when those interactions distort the data provided to the autonomy. In some ways, validating VANE vehicle models is the most straightforward component of building trust in VANE simulations. This is because we can use military production verification test reports to verify vehicle performance metrics, such as acceleration, braking, turning, and stability. We develop virtual versions of standard vehicle performance tests to directly compare the behavior of vehicle models with their real-world counterparts. Each model goes through a calibration process where we fine-tune model parameters until the virtual test results are as close as possible to the verification reports. Once we have developed accurate environment, sensor, and vehicle models, we can perform software-in-the-loop simulations where the autonomy behavior is the only unknown variable. We collaborate with partners such as the Ground Vehicle System Center, or GVSC, to provide our simulation tools and our expertise in the simulations. In the case of GVSC, they will generally handle the physical prototyping and system integration of a UGV concept, while we provide the simulation architecture to support their development and evaluation cycles. Together, we work to demonstrate new capabilities to the broader DoD community at events like Project Convergence and transition robust autonomy systems to programs such as Leader Follower. Army robotic platforms will be a force multiplier that reduces the risk to the warfighter by getting them out of harm's way. But autonomy development presents unique and complex challenges, which is why we work closely with our partners to ensure we've accurately modeled their systems. We then can use VANE to shed light on those hard questions and accelerate autonomy development.